Yo, what it do, fam? What it do? How y'all doing today? Welcome, y'all. The first little live stream of some knowledge, you know, some crystal knowledge. I think I might do this every week, you know, it depends, you know. But I want to just jump right into it, you know, let you know what this is about. So this live Instagram feed is about crystals. How to use them, the properties they have for us, you know, that we can use them on a daily basis. Things that can help us within our life each and every day, kind of help us sustain life in a great manner, right? So, you know, I have three stones. I'ma start out with, you know, describing them, let them know what they are, where they from, and what they, you know, good for. You know, so we can jump right into that. And after, you know, I give y'all, you know, some details on these crystals, you know, I'ma see if y'all have any questions or anything y'all want to input into what I got, okay? So we're gonna kick it off with some crystals I have, okay? And some of these crystals y'all might already know about, you know, but you know, it's still good to know about them more and what you can do with them. So the first stone I'm gonna show you guys, right, is my lovely sunstone. Y'all see that sunstone? Okay, nice orange texture, kind of, you know, nice, you know, sunstone is a great stone. You know, it helps with your leadership skills, it helps you with strength, you know, abundance of blessings, you know. It's a great stone for like your everyday usage, you know. It helps in heighten in male energy, so, you know, you need some more of that testosterone kind of boost through your day, your energy. You know, that's a good stone to hold on to, meditate to on a daily basis. Also, it's a stone for your sacral chakra, you know, more of your creativity side. And it helps with your solar plexus. So it works with both of those in a great way, you know. Sunstone. This is sunstone I'm talking about, okay? This stone is found in the U.S. and Canada, India. Pretty much in these countries only. Norway is another one they have them in. This is a great stone. It helps with manifestation, mental clarity, you know, vitality. It gives you that boost of energy when you need it. Also, it's really, really great for leaders, okay? Also, it works well with moonstone and labradorite, amber, and jet. So you can hold all those stones together, sunstone, moonstone, jet, labradorite. You know, it helps enhance those properties and it works well for them. So basically with the stones, you can sleep with them in your pillowcase, right? You know, meditate with them. The reason why you have to do these things specifically because we have energies and they have properties, right? So it's like a trade-off with us. You know, once we hold these crystals every day on a consistent basis, meditate with them, you know, just have them in your area, have them around you, your energy, they're going to absorb your energy and work with you, their properties. So it's like a trade-off for those, you know what I'm saying? So sunstone is a great stone to have, you know. So if y'all don't have that, make sure y'all pick that up, okay? Sunstone, that's a great stone. All right. Next stone, one of my favorites. My favorite stone, I know y'all love this stone. It was a very popular stone during Valentine's Day. This is a rose quartz. Right? I know a lot of y'all know about rose quartz as just being a love stone, which is true. It's actually one of the ultimate love stones. It works. It's a very great heart chakra stone, okay? And it helps with love and gentleness. You know, it helps you with your emotional healing, releasing stress. And it also helps you, you know, unite with the divine, the outer experience, the spiritual realm, you know what I'm saying? It helps you connect with them. It's a pure stone of love in your partner, in your oneself, in your children, in your family, in your social life. You know, it helps you get the overall love and compassion that, you know, some that might have inside or instilled in them yet. Once again, meditating with these stones will help you get some of these properties within, okay? So on a consistent basis, you just can't have a stone sitting there for decorations, which they are beautiful, right? But it's just a stone if you don't touch them, you know, just decorations. So make sure y'all meditate, sleep with them, read a book with them, have them in your area every day, okay? Also, rose quartz helps with your heart chakra. It helps heal you from past life trauma, old wounds that you need to heal from. It helps alleviate that stress and emotion. It helps with emotional balance. with that. It also helps with your lower chakras too. So, you know, love stone also helps with your soul and your sacral. Also can be a root chakra stone for grounding, okay? Rose quartz works well with moldavite. If y'all have a moldavite, moldavite is a top stone right now. I see everybody asking about. So if you have moldavite and a rose quartz, what that would do, it would enhance the love to a capacity. It would give you that overall gentleness, love, affection, intimacy, understanding, anything you need within, it will bring it out a million times more, okay? So big ups to rose quartz. I love that stone. If y'all don't have that stone also, once again, go get it. All right. So I'm gonna do my last stone today. I'm gonna make this a short, it's my first one, but my last favorite stone I love and I recommend for everyone to hold or have with them on a daily basis, right, is black tourmaline, my best friend, my homie, my OG, you know what I mean? Black tourmaline, I don't care who you are, what you've been through, whatever, you need a black tourmaline in your life. Only because, reason being, black tourmaline, it transmutes negative energy into a positive outlet, even within you. So if you got a, you know, a mind full of anger or hate within or something within, it'll transmute all that. You know, so you won't have to even put that out there like this. So within you or people you encountering, it also helps with people who deal with difficult place of work, living space. It helps you alleviate all that worry, fear, anger, distress. I love black tourmaline, right? Black tourmaline is a great stone. Also cleanse your whole aura and your etheric body field. So it protects you from things that spiritually might come against you or attack you. You know, so your aura and your etheric, that's more just spirituality. So it definitely protects that from unwanted energies, unwanted spirits, whatever you might call it, whatever, things that you don't want to deal with. That's what black tourmaline does, okay? Meditating with black tourmaline, right? Sleeping with it in your pillowcase can provide you with a refreshing dose of cleansing with your whole etheric and aura body. Your whole auric body, it helps cleanse that too. So black tourmaline, it cleanses that for you and protects you and purify you. Love black tourmaline. Get you one if you don't have that, okay? So the best way to store your crystals, okay? The best way to store your crystals, so you want to treat your crystals like they're your children, all right? You treat them well, they'll do you right. Or anything you feel mostly or you care about, you do crystals just like this. You want to keep them in a safe place, tucked away. You can have them out somewhere, but somewhere out in maybe a bedroom. But you don't want them too much, you know, around different, you know, different energies. But you can definitely have them in a sack, a black sack. A little nice case, something to cover them, you know. So anything like that, just to kind of take care of them, you know, keep them, you know, take care of them nice and gently, okay? So that should answer your question right there. Black tourmaline, yes, ultimate grounding stone. So if you need some root chakra work, which I feel everybody need to work on when they're dealing with their chakras, you must start the root. And black tourmaline is the grounding stone for that, and hematite. Those two, you definitely should start work, you know, getting and dealing with on a daily to be grounded too. And, you know, that's a good one. I like that. Okay. Which crystals should not be stored together? That's a good question because I get that a lot. A lot of people are like, man, I can't put this stone together. Nah. That's not true. You put any stone together because the stones, the more you work with them, the more you have them in your space and your energy, whatever, they're going to recognize what you need and what they need to work on within. Just like medicine, you take medicine, right? A group of medicine, whatever, some you can take some, you know, whatever. But if you take a lot of them, they're going to locate what needs to be worked on, what needs to be fixed, headache, stomach ache, whatever. Crystal, same way. It locates the energy that needs to be worked on, off balance or not balance. You know, it'll definitely locate that and help you gather yourself. So any stones can go together. All right. So look, while y'all gather your questions about these crystals or whatnot, I'm going to play some music. I'm going to play my next single. I'm about to drop. So, y'all just hold on for a minute. Think of some questions too, you heard me? April 2nd. Stars. Think of some questions too. Yeah.
We gon' make our own way. We gotta stay with the man. Don't give a damn what they say. We gon' make our own way. We gotta stay with the man.
Let's see what we got. Okay. Okay. Yes, so Noah. So basically that's like, it seemed like you had like some intense energy, right? So you had some intense energy, sound like some excitement energy, because the Undertaker, that sound like something you like to, you know, a wrestler you like. So it probably seemed like you had some excited energy, which you would use a howlite. Howlite is a calming stone. Howlite calms you overall. It's overall calming stone. Also use an amethyst as well to alleviate that, to kind of calm you down from the shaking. You know, the tremors, whatever, you know, it seemed like you were just overactive in your excitement, you know, so those stones are great for calming. Amethyst and howlite, you know, if y'all don't have those, get those too. Those are good for stress relieving as well. Keeps you calm and have you clarity in the mind too, okay? So I see we don't have any more questions. So I'm gonna go over these crystals, okay, one more time, okay? The crystals I was talking about today, or tonight, rose quartz. Right, remember that one? Love stone, gentleness, all right? Sunstone, leadership, vitality, right? Creativity, black tourmaline, protection, grounding, absorb negative energy, transfer into a positive outlet. Those stones you need to start working with. Meditate with your crystals, right? Because a crystal is just a crystal unless you activate it by meditating, sleeping with it, having it around you each and every day, so it can absorb your energy and give its properties, okay? That's how y'all do that. So I want to thank y'all for tuning into my first crystal lesson knowledge Q&A. I appreciate you. Hopefully I might do it next Sunday. I'll make it a Sunday ritual, so we can do that. Crystal learning. If y'all have any questions, y'all let me know. I appreciate y'all. Thank you. Have a great evening. We're going to start our week off great. Mwah. Arthur Guy Beats, April 2nd. New singles.